Hello and welcome you all in this video tutorial. This video is for class 9th, chapter number 4, Operating System part 1. Now dear student, in previous chapter also we discussed about operating system. Now in this chapter we are discussing more about operating system. We will discuss objective of an operating system, component of operating system, why we need operating system, functions of operating system. Along with this we discuss types of operating system and commonly used operating system like Windows operating system and mobile operating system. So these all things we are going to discuss in this video. So first of all I am going to start, what is an operating system? So dear student, before this also I told you, an operating system is act as an interface between user and computer system. Interface means this, as you all know, as a user we are not able to directly communicate with hardware, so for that we need a translator, a set of programs through which we can communicate with the hardware. And in previous video also I told you, hardware only understood 0 and 1. If you observe this figure carefully, then here you can see a user first interact with applications, then application interact with operating system, then operating system send the instruction to the hardware. Again in the same way, hardware respond to operating system respond to application, and then through application user gets their result or output. It means dear student, in short we can say that an operating system controls and monitors the execution of all the programs and applications. It also performs basic tasks such as recognizing input from the keyboard, sending output to the monitor, managing files and directories on the storage device, and control peripheral devices also. Peripheral devices like printer, projector, speaker and many more connected devices that control through operating system. In short, you can say that without operating system, we are not able to use computer. If I explain with the help of a example, then suppose you have a car, and if you want to move that particular car, so for that you need two basic things. First you need a platform, second you need a driver, and without these two things you are not able to move your car. The platform here, platform that is nothing but a road, driver who know how to drive a car. By using these two you can move a car. The same here, without platform we are not able to run an application, and if you are not able to run an application, then as a user you can't able to do anything on a computer. So if you want to use computer, so first of all you need a platform, and that platform is your operating system. That is other matter, you are using which operating system. The all operating system responsibility is same. It acts as an interface between user and computer system, and it control and manage all the connected devices, and along with this it control all the peripheral devices also. If we discuss some common example of operating systems, so we are having so many operating systems like Windows, Mac, Linux, Unix. Apart from this, so many operating systems are available in the market. But the most popular which we are using right now is Windows for computer system. Next, if we discuss the components of operating system, the operating system having two components, two major components. First one is shell, second one is kernel. So before this, let me tell you what is shell and what is kernel. Shell handles the interaction with user. Kernel handles the interaction with hardware. These two components are the internal part of operating system. If you observe this figure, then here a user will not directly communicate with the hardware. First, user communicate with cell, then cell communicate with kernel, and from kernel, hardware gets instructions. So likewise, we can say cell acts as an interface to the operating system, or an interface to operating system is called cell. It is the outermost layer of operating system and manages interaction between you and operating system. A cell provides a way for you to communicate with operating system either interactively, it means input from keyboard, or as a cell script. A cell script is a sequence of system commands that are stored in a file. Next, if we discuss about kernel, so kernel is actually a heart of operating system. In short, you can say that a kernel is a core component of an operating system, which acts as an interface between application and the data processing being performed at the hardware level. When an operating system is loaded into memory, the kernel loads first and remains in memory until the operating system is shut down. It means, dear student, when you start your computer system, then firstly kernel loaded and it remain in the memory until you shut down your computer. The kernel provides and manages the memory until the operating system is on computer resources and allow the other program to run and use these resources. The kernel also sets up the memory address space from application, load the file with application code into memory and set the execution step for programs. In short, whenever you start your computer, first kernel load, and after this it will load all the essential files and programs into the memory. Next, we discuss the function that kernel performs. So kernel performs some functions. The first one is processor or process management. Next is memory management, device management, interrupt handling. Next is input-output communication. These all are the functions which a kernel is responsible for their performance and their execution. If we discuss about the types of kernel, so there are two types of kernel, monolithic and microkernel. Next, if we discuss about cell, so just now I told you, a cell is a simple software which acts as an interface between various operating system functions and services. In layman world, your interface of operating system is called cell. Cell provides a way for you to communicate with operating system. This communication is carried out either interactively or as a cell script. Next thing, if we are going to discuss, then that is functions of operating system. Before this, dear student, I want to discuss one more thing, why we need an operating system. I think till now it is very clear why we need operating system, because without operating system we are not able to give instruction to the hardware, and hardware need instruction like what to do, when to do and how to do. And these all instructions a user cannot give directly. So that is why we need a set of programs, nothing but operating system. Next, I am going to discuss about functions of operating system. As you all know, dear student, operating system manages so many functions. First one is processor management. Processor management means an operating system manages the working of processor by allocating various jobs to it. It also ensures that each process and application receive enough time by processor to function properly. It also tries to utilize as many processor cycle as possible to the real time work. It is these process rather than application which are controlled, managed and executed by operating system. In short, we can say that in multi-programming environment, like as we are using computer, so our computer is multi-programming. At a time we can run more than one program or more than one application, but we have only one processor. The operating system responsibility is to deal with various process with the help of single processor, and it allocate a time slot for each process, and as that time slot for that process is completed, the processor switch to next process. So like this, our operating system manages the processor. Next is memory management. The operating system manages the primary memory and or main memory. Main memory is made of a large array of byte or word, where each byte or word assigned a certain address. An operating system manages the sharing of internal memory among multiple applications. It means, dear student, you know, in your computer so many applications are installed, like MS Word, PowerPoint, Photoshop, maybe Visual Basic, or so many application you are having, installed application you are having in your computer, but you have only one memory, and that memory is shared among different applications that are installed in your computer. So these all are the responsibility of your operating system to manage memory along with the various applications. That is why this is possible. If you search any particular file, then immediately you are able to get that particular file, because your operating system manages all the memory or all the applications memory, all the installed applications that are sharing that particular memory, so that whenever you need any particular file, so easily you get it. Next thing is device management. An operating system manages device communication via their respective drivers. It performs the following activity for device management: keep track of all devices connected to the system and designates a program responsibility for every device known as input-output controller. An operating system controls the working of all input and output devices. It receives the request for those devices, perform a specific task and communicate back to the requesting process. Not only this, you're operating, if suppose any of the hardware or device is not working properly, then it's the responsibility of the operating system to give a alert message to the user, this particular hardware is not working properly. So this way, operating system manages the devices. Next is security. The operating system provides various techniques which assures the integrity and confidentiality of users. It means if you using computer system, then you need to protect your computer with password, and that password is stored through your operating system, and it not allow any unauthorized access to any program or any other user until the user not provide correct password. This way, operating system secure all the stored data and applications. Next is job scheduling. Operating system keep track of time and resources used by various tasks and users. This inform can be used to track resource uses for a particular user or group of users. In multitasking operating system, where multiple program runs at the same time, operating system determines which application should run in which order and how much time should be allotted for each application in turn. It means among multiple processes, operating system responsibility is to give a certain time to each and every application and priority also. Like for example, if you are going in a bank and you are standing in a queue, then you wait for your turn according to the queue and you will get a priority according to your work when you reach to the counter. The same way here also, operating system manages the process according to the priority and it will give a time slot to that process to utilize the processor resource. Last is file management. A file system is organized in directories for efficient or easy navigation or uses. In short, dear student, an operating system keeps a track of information regarding creation, deletion, transfer, copy and storage of each and every file that are stored inside hard disk or inside memory. That is why this will happen if you want detail of any particular file, that doesn't matter, that particular file is created at what date and what time. Immediately you get all the details related to that file. Details in the sense creation, transfer, copy, storage, size, each and every detail you are getting regarding that particular file if you want to know the details. These facilities are collectively known as file system, and this is managed by operating system. So these all are the functions of operating system. Next, if we discuss the types of operating system, we have so many types of operating system. First one is single user operating system. So by name it is clear, these operating system could support only one user at a time. The most popular single user operating system are Windows 3.1, MS Windows 95, MS DOS, and many more operating system are there. Next is GUI, graphical user interface. This operating system is a graphic based and interactive in nature. The command were replaced by graphic symbol displayed on computer screen. Dear student, right now the Windows operating system that we are using is based on graphical user interface. Why? Because if you want to perform any task, suppose you want to open my computer, so simply what you have to do, you have to simply click on that particular icon, my computer icon. When you click, you are getting my computer window. So that is why GUI interface is a user friendly interface, and it is interactive in nature. Because of this, the command were replaced by graphical symbol displayed on the screen. Some example of GUI based operating systems are Windows 98, Windows XP, Windows Vista, Windows 8, 8.1, 10, and in mobile operating system, we have Android, we have Symbian, we have iOS, and we have Windows Mobile operating system also. That all are based on GUI. Next is multi-user operating system. Multi-user means more than one user allow to access the computer at the same time or different time. Some of the operating system which falls in categories such as Linux, Unix, Microsoft Windows 2000, Windows 8, Windows 10, these all are the operating system that we have is multi-user. It means at a time more than one user can access the computer. Next is multitasking operating system. Multitasking operating system can perform more than one task at a single instant of time is called multitasking. An operating system which is capable of doing multitask or executing process while using common processing resource like CPU is called multitasking operating system. Today, most of the operating system falls under categories. For example, Unix, Windows XP, Windows 7, Windows 8, and Windows 10. Next is real-time operating system, RTOS. Dear student, please mind, here I have mentioned RIOS, this one is RTOS. RTOS is designed to handle real-life scenario and problems, such as operating system have capability to prioritize the process, minimize execution time, and work independently with no interdependencies. Real-time operating system we are using in real-time scenario, like we are using real-time operating system in reservation, weather forecasting, and whatever places that are working in real time or that are working 24/7, there we are using real time operating system. Next, we have distributed operating system. Distributed operating system runs on a computer which are located in different geographical area, interconnected through network. It controls these interconnected system and makes them appear to be a single computer. It allow all the links, machines to access data, software, and process tasks over the common network for different computer of their location on the globe. It means it works on distributed geographical area, interconnected or connected through network lines. So these all about types of operating system. Next, commonly used operating system. So dear student, commonly we are using the most commonly operating system that we are using right now for computer system is Windows. Windows is an operating system, act as an interface between user and computer, and it is based on graphical user interface. It has been developed by Microsoft and was introduced on November 20, 1985, and just now I told you it is based on GUI. Next commonly used operating system that we have is Unix. Unix is very powerful operating system with a wide spectrum of powerful features. It was developed in 1969 by a group of AT&T employees at Bell Lab, and since then it under constant development. And this Unix operating system also have graphical user interface similar to Windows, and it offers character user interface also. Next we have Unix operating system, Solaris operating system, and BOSS, Bharat operating system solution. Solaris is a product of Sun Microsystem, and BOSS, Bharat operating system, is GNU Linux based operating system. It is discovered or open source software throughout the India. Next, if we talk about mobile operating system, so nowadays the most popular mobile operating system that we have is Android operating system. Android is the world's most popular mobile operating system. It is an open source Linux based platform initially developed by Android Inc. in October 2003, and later on purchased by Google Inc. in 2005. The green robot is the logo of Android operating system. Android operating system turns your phone into a powerful web browser, game console, and personal assistant all in one. Next we have Symbian operating system. Dear student, this is also a mobile operating system, most popular operating system before Android. Symbian was originally developed by Symbian Limited, and it currently maintained by Accenture. Next we have iOS. This you all know, iOS is a mobile operating system developed by Apple. It is the world's most advanced mobile operating system. It was originally released in 2007 and is used to run in iPhone, iPad, iPod Touch, and formerly was known as iPhone OS. Next we have Windows mobile operating system also. It is a mobile operating system developed by Microsoft for a smartphone and mobile device based on Windows CE kernel. It is designed to lock and operate similar to desktop version of Microsoft Windows. It has given a whole new dimension of emailing and documentation. Some of the popular mobile Windows mobile operating systems are Nokia, Lumia, Samsung, Windows Phone 8C by HTC. Now these all are the mobile operating system that we have now, and this is all about operating system. Dear student, I hope you will understood. Next, more detail we will discuss in next video. Thank you everyone.